Have you recently acquired a camper or an RV that you're looking to insulate with spray foam? Let's talk about it. So this is a super popular topic right now on the social medias. People asking if they have a camper or an RV, can you spray foam or use injection foam to insulate that camper? It kind of can get a little complicated. I'm gonna keep it as simple as possible. First, let's break it into two categories. We'll talk about spray foam and let's talk about RetroFoam. First of all, spray foam. If you have any sort of gutted or open surface, if you've bought a camper or a van, like cargo van that you're converting or something like that, if you've bought any sort of structure and you've gutted it and the outside walls are exposed, absolutely spray foam is probably the absolute best option for you. So yes, spray foam is absolutely something you should be thinking about if you have a gutted or exposed van, RV, camper, whatever the case is. But if it's not, if it's still finished off on the inside, then spray foam is not likely going to be a good candidate for your specific camper. So let's say you do have some sort of a camper with enclosed walls or ceilings or floors or whatever, and you're looking to insulate that. Can you use injection foam, like RetroFoam injection foam? Yes, most likely you can, but the install process can be a little tricky. And by tricky, I mean invasive. The crew will likely have to drill into something, most likely your interior walls or your interior ceiling or wherever the case is. And the patching of it, again, that's where you may not like the aesthetics after the fact, because those interiors, not always the easiest to patch. Sometimes they are. Like if you just bought an RV off the shelf somewhere, that interior, it's not necessarily the same stuff that houses are made out of. So the patching of those access holes could look a little rough. Again, this is all dependent on your specific camper, your specific situation. Just keep in mind, that's usually one of the struggles when it comes to trying to inject foam into a camper of some kind, because you have to make access and the patchwork can be a little ugly sometimes, depending on what the material is on the wall or the ceiling, whatever have you. Your aesthetics, if that's super important to you, really make sure you go over that with your contractor, because it can be tricky to make it look pristine afterwards. So I want to summarize real quick with, again, breaking this into two categories. If you have a gutted or wide open van or camper, spray foam's your way to go. If you have an enclosed camper that's all finished off and you're okay with maybe some cosmetic marks on the inside that you can strategically cover up somehow, then RetroFoam could be a good option for you. But again, those are your qualifying questions to ask yourself. So if you think you're ready to take the next step and talk to a contractor about this, go to our link below to our Find a Dealer page, where you can find your local RetroFoam dealer and make that camper more comfortable today. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.